Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we will be discussing about line balancing in operations management. Line balancing is something like which is related to the production layout, where the plant where the production has to be carried out, right? And what do you mean by line balancing? It means like, let's suppose if you want to produce a product, and to produce a product you require different workstations, right? So at every workstation you need to assign certain tasks so that the product can be completed, and the main aim is that we want the workstations to be utilized to the maximum, their waiting time should be reduced, plus your production rate is maximized, right? Now, what is the definition of line balancing? It is a procedure in which you are assigning the task along the assembly line to the workstation so that each workstation has approximately same amount of work, right? So we are basically, what we are doing at every workstation, we are dividing some task to them, right? It is like every workstation should work, they should not be idle. If they are idle, that means the company's resources are getting wasted. Their idle time is there, their efficiency is less, their productivity is less, which the company does not want. So they want to assign the task to all the workstations in such a way that efficiency is maximized, idle time is reduced, and this is what, when we do, this is known as line balancing. Now, what is the main objective of line balancing? Main objective of line balancing is we want to minimize the idle time of the workers. And we want that the production rate, it should be met. Whatever is our production target, it should be achieved, right? Now we are going to arrange the workstations so that the output of one is an input to the next. Like over here, we are, this is workstation number one, this is workstation number two, this is workstation number three, and this is workstation number four. So what we are doing, suppose over here we gave some input. We gave some input over here, right? And whatever input we gave, and the output of the first workstation will be the input of the second workstation. Second workstation output will be the input to the third workstation, and so on. And this layout, it involves that we are going to assign one or more of the tasks required to make a product to the workstation. We are assigning all those tasks which are necessary to produce the product to all the workstations. Now in this, there is one terminology used here, cycle time. What is the cycle time? It is the maximum time which is allowed at every workstation to complete the task on that particular station. Whatever tasks will be given to that particular workstation, in the maximum time in which they have to complete those tasks, that is known as cycle time. And there is one output rate. Output rate is equals to operating time divided by cycle time, right? Operating time is like for how many hours the organization is working, and cycle time is the previous one. And how to calculate the cycle time? Cycle time is operating time divided by desired output. Operating time for how long the company is working, and what is your target of producing the output? That is the desired output rate. All right. And how to calculate the number of workstations? The number of workstations are calculated by submission of T divided by cycle time. What is submission of T? Sum of all the task time. That is equal to the submission T. Now there are two rules by which we can assign the tasks to the workstations. First rule is assign the task in the order of most following task. Second rule is that we can do the assignment in accordance to the greatest positional weight. Now in this particular video, we will be discussing this first rule, that is assign the task in the order of most following task. All right. Now let's see the question. Now this is the question to us, like first is you have to draw the precedence diagram. This is assuming an 8-hour work day, right? Compute the cycle time needed to obtain. So this is the question. So we will first of all focus on this table which is given to us. There are how many, there are tasks given to us, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. There are total 8 tasks given to us, and for all these 8 tasks, certain predecessors are given to you. Predecessors means some sequence. These all tasks they have to be performed in a particular sequence, and this column is going to tell you the sequence in which the task has to be performed. For example, like A task and the C task, they don't have any predecessor. A task and C task, they don't have any predecessor. That means these are the independent tasks. The first task which we have to assign or which we can assign is the A or C task. Then after A, we can assign B. After C, we can assign D. After B, we can assign E and D, E, F and so on. And for every task, the time is given to us, right? Now, our first step is we have to draw the precedence diagram. Now, let's see the precedence diagram. This is what we have to do, the precedence diagram. This is the table. I have shown it over here also for your reference. As I told you in the previous slide, A task and C task, they don't have any predecessor, right? So these tasks are independent tasks. So my task will be shown like this, A and C. Now after A, I have B. And after C, I have D. So it will be shown like this, right? Task B is followed by task A, task D is followed by task C, and this has been achieved in step 2, right? Now next is in step 3, what will happen? Task E is followed by B task. You can see here after B we have E. Now in the next step we have after D and E, we have F like this, right? Then after F, I have G, and after G, I have H. So this is how you have to draw the precedence diagram, all right? Next step is, if we go by the question, next is they are asking you that assuming an 8-hour work day. Now, in a day, they are working for 8 hours. This is the operating time of the organization. They want to know what is the cycle time, so that the output is 400 units per day. So they have given you the desired output. The desired output is 400 units and the operating time is 8 hours. Now since it is 8 hours, the time given to us is in the minutes. So 8 into 6480 divided by 400 and it is giving me 1.2 as the cycle time. All right. Third thing is number of workstations. Now for calculating the number of workstations, you need to have summation of T, task time. Sum of all the task time, that is equal to 3.8. Sum of task time is 3.8 and your cycle time is 1.2. Now this is coming out to be 3.17. Your cycle time is 3.17. Now what we have to do is, the number of workstations, they cannot be in decimals, all right? So for that, you have to do the rounding off. Now for doing the rounding off, you will always do the round off to the higher digit, not to the lower one. So if it is 3.17, you will round it to the 4. So the number of workstations are 4. Next is, you have to make the assignments according to the number of followers, right? That the task which will have the highest number of followers, that task will be assigned first. And later on, the next task will be assigned. And if there is a tie, you will use the time of the task as the tiebreaker. That I will show you during the assignment only. Like we have the first workstation. At first workstation, the cycle time is 1.2. All right. Now the eligible tasks are A and C. Why? Because these were the two independent tasks. If you people can see from here, these two tasks are independent tasks, A and C. So my two eligible tasks are A and C. Now A has how many followers? B, E, F, G, H. If I count them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And C has 4 followers. So out of A and C, A has 5 followers. That means they have maximum followers. So I will assign A first. And the time of A is 0.2. And I will do this, I will subtract this 0.2 from this 1.2 and it is going to give me the remaining time as 1 minute. Now, the time left at first workstation is 1 minute. Now, my next eligible task will be C and B. C is already eligible. A has been allocated. After A, I can do the B assignment also. So, C and B, they are both have the same number of followers, right? if I'll show you again in the diagram, B has four followers, C has four followers. So there is a tie. What is the time of B? B time is, if I show you the time of B is 0.2 and time of C is 0.8. So I will assign C first. Why? Because the time of C is more than the time of B. So this was used as a tiebreaker. Like this I will do here, and 0.8 is assigned. Now the time left at workstation is 0.2. I will subtract 0.8 from 1. Theek hai? So that is how 0.2 is left. Next eligible task will be B and D. B will be assigned because B has 4 followers and D has 3 followers. B will be assigned and the time left at workstation is 0. So I have utilized the first workstation completely. I'll move to the second workstation. At the second workstation, again the cycle time is 1.2 and the task eligible are E and D. Out of E and D, D will be assigned first because the time of D is 0.6, right? And the remaining time left is 0.6. Then next eligible task is only E. E 0.3, time left is 0.3. Now F, next eligible task is F. The time of F is more and it cannot be assigned. So the 0.3 time which is left at the second workstation, it is the idle time of the second workstation, and I'll move to the third workstation where the cycle time is 1.2. I will assign the F task. The task time is 1 minute and the time remaining is 0.2 now. 1.2 mein se 1 minus kiya to 0.2 time is left. Next eligible task is G. G time is 0.4, but time here left is 0.2. So this is the idle time of third workstation. G 0.4, we will move to the fourth workstation and the time here left will be 0.8. Next eligible task is H. H assigned, 0.5 time is left. So if I add them all, this is the total idle time of all the workstations, which is equal to 1 minute. My next task is, I have to do the calculation of the idle time. What is the formula to calculate the idle time? It will be total idle time, that was 1 minute, divided by number of workstations, that is 4, into cycle time, that is 1.2, into 100. Now this is your idle percentage. If I will subtract it from 100, I will get the efficiency, right? So this will be the efficiency of the system, 79.17%. Alright, so this was all about line balancing in operations management according to the rule of followers. If you like this video, then please do subscribe to my channel and mention your comments, mention your views in the comment section. Thank you.